Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Dom, and leave a big thumbs up for the brand new Mac Pro. Go ahead, make all the trash can jokes you want, because this is the most beautiful and powerful trash can that I've ever owned. All jokes aside, we are going to take a look at this brand new powerful machine, and starting at the top here, on the left side, we do have our lock switch that will allow us to unlock the casing and remove it, followed by our audio input and headphone jack. Then we also have four USB 3.0 ports, followed by six Thunderbolt 2 ports, dual gigabit Ethernet ports, our power button and HDMI output, and our AC power connector. Along the top side of the Mac Pro, we do have our air vent here, and that lip can also be used as a handle to lift the Mac Pro and carry it around. As I mentioned up at the top here, we do have our lock button. If we slide it over to the right, we have the ability to remove the casing from the Mac Pro and expose what's under the hood, which we are going to take a look at right now. Aside from the ports on the back, if we go ahead and rotate this here, you'll notice that we do have one bay of RAM sticks here, and we can easily remove those by pressing the button up at the top. You can insert your new RAM and then you can go ahead and press it down to close it and you'll be all set and ready to go. Now on the other side here, we do have one of our GPUs, and actually in the middle there is our PCIe based flash storage. Because of the screw located up here at the top, it's very likely that we will see third-party storage solutions for the Mac Pro in the future. Now, if we go ahead and rotate this to the other side, you'll notice that we do have another GPU here on the outside, and the CPU is on the logic board, which is in the center of the Mac Pro attached to the heatsink. Last but not least, we do have another bay containing two more sticks of RAM for a total of four packed inside of the new Mac Pro. And just as easy as it came off, you can slide the casing right back on and lock that switch there, and you are all set and ready to go. Once the Mac Pro is plugged in and powered on, if we rotate it here, you'll notice that there are LED lights that illuminate around the ports, allowing you to see them a little better, and eventually they will turn off, but it's definitely this type of attention to detail that makes the new Mac Pro so beautiful. Moving on to benchmarks, in Geekbench 3, running a 64-bit test, we actually scored a single-core score of 3,564 and a multi-core score of 20,494. Coming up next is NovaBench, and here we got a NovaBench score of 1923, and the individual scores are down below, and I will be sure to link both of these benchmarks down below in the description in case you want to check out the details. Moving along to Blackmagic disk speed test, we saw write speeds well over 700 and read speeds way above 900, so that is definitely awesome. And for our final test with Cinebench R15, OpenGL came in around 76.1 frames per second, and the CPU score was 945. So I hope you enjoyed this unboxing and overview of the all-new redesigned Mac Pro, and if you did, be sure to hit that thumbs up button, and also if you're not already, subscribe for more Mac Pro content in the future. Let me know what you think about the Mac Pro down in the comments section below. Thanks again for watching, everybody. This is Dom, and have a great day.